okay? Everyone okay? All making sense? At 35 millimeter. Because I know it fits on the page. 35, yeah. Okay, I think everyone's almost getting to that. Now, to build this further out, we have new intersections, and on those intersections, so that you don't change your compass radius. This bit stays the same. What we have is these six circles have now created points. So that set of points, we do another circle on each one. And you see this goes through that center and that center there. So you follow that all the way around. If you've been accurate, what you should find is a satisfying little click when the pencil goes through the hole. So when it's here, it'll pass through one, two points that are centers of circles already and have a compass hole in them. If you find you're getting lost with where these points are, what I did here with drawing the circles around these points can be useful, because the next step we're gonna draw ones here. But if you don't have those and you're doing this for the first time, it's kind of easy to get lost, so you can always do a little colored mark around it. Right, I'm marking a different color the next circle, which is these ones. So when we finish doing this next set, this is what you should have on your page. So you keep going, so these six points here, and then it'll be good. We've got it. Have to sit around waiting for a bit. All right, I think everyone's nearly there, so we'll move on. Right, the next step, we're going to divide the central circle into 12. Now, by following from this point, you can see the six petals. That's going to divide into six equal sections. So first of all, we put that in color. So we go through. So from the middle, you're going through the petal. That shape there is the petal. It's going to go through. You've got about four or five points to line up. And put that all the way through, like that, and do that three times around the central circle. Okay, so that's the basic six. Now, to do that central one into 12, we also have points. So if I line this, 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 I get the division in between. So as I was saying, just take your time when you position the ruler, try and get through all those points. Just immediately you should be able to see how accurate your circles are. And if your points aren't quite accurate, then just try and go for an average of all of them. Okay, everyone okay with that? You're missing, these, yeah. So you add those first, because it will help doing all the other divisions. It gives you more points and more accurate. Okay, now we have one last ring of circles. Okay, let me just explain. If you were continuing the creation diagram, then you would use these points where the circle overlaps. That's not what we're going to do. We're adding a different circle to be able to create the tiling that we need. And those are, so here you see the top diagonals. I'll just circle them here. That is right, yeah. There. That one. That one. That one. Four, five, six. Now the radius is exactly the same as all the others. Now this one will be a bit different. It will only go through that center, and it won't create the petals, so don't worry about that. That's fine. Yeah, this one here, okay. And then you have that point, and then you put a circle there, okay. And here as well. Yeah, except that one's gone a bit high, but that's okay, don't worry. Yeah, fine. One extra tip with using the compass, when you position, so you're going to draw with one hand, instead of doing like this to put the point down, use your left hand to guide it. Because you want it to be as precise as possible. If you have a line that's that thick, you want to go right in the middle of the line. So use your left hand to position it. It'll be much steadier than if you're trying to do that and just drop it in the right place. Okay. Okay. The next step, so we're going to draw this using layers of tracing paper. Because then when you finish, you've got the pattern just on its own on one sheet without all the construction, and also you can refer back to it and see the stages of how it's been developed. So the next step, we just put a sheet of tracing paper over it. Now you should have a few sheets, and is there some masking tape? Do you have tape? No. Shula, is there some tape? Yeah. Is there... Sorry, forgot. With the masking tape, make sure you do a strip all the way along the top, because if it moves like this side to side, everything's going to get lost. So use a long strip along the top, stick them together. We're going to add probably three or four layers of tracing paper, so just bear that in mind. Something you might find useful with the tracing paper, if you fold the top bit like that and tear that off, so there's room for the masking tape. Otherwise you have to fold over the top. So here, if you tear that off, it's going to fit better with, it's just going to give you some room for the tape. Okay, so it's slightly shorter. Okay, everyone ready with tracing paper? Right, let me just go through the next few steps so you see where we're going. We've got a couple more lines to add. Then these are the three basic forms that we're going to build the grid from. Hexagon surrounded by square, triangle. And that builds to that. And then in the outer circle, we put more hexagons and a few more squares. Now at the moment, the thing that's missing is that point there. We don't know where that is. So we do a couple more construction lines, then we'll draw the grid. Now these next two lines, you can do it quite faintly with a light pencil. When you're drawing these ones, do it with a slightly heavier pencil. I think you should have, 2H. So 2H, you do the two long lines. Use HB for the grid. This large six-pointed star, and how that works is from the center points. So you've got these six circles around the outside. You're gonna not join one to the next, but join that one to that one. So you make a big triangle. And when you extend those lines, so that point to that point, you can see here, this is the point I need. But we'll put the whole line in because it'll be useful later on. There you can see this large triangle there, joining these outer circles, and then I do the same the other way up to make a six-pointed star. So there are three shapes here. We're going to build the whole grid now. So this one you do in the heavier pencil, HB pencil, and you can make the lines a bit stronger. So you see in this, the first circle we drew in the middle is now divided with the petals into six. So the first thing we do is put the hexagon in the center. So this is the first central shape, is that hexagon. Can you see that? Well, you can see it in both here, this one. And it's just joining up. You see this petal, another petal there. You're just joining up those. Okay, then next, probably easiest to draw the square. And the way I would suggest to do that is if you line up this point and this point on the hexagon, you'll see there's a point here. So if I draw that line in, and from here to here, like that. Thank you. So hopefully you can see a bit more clearly. I've used a thicker pen. So now these ones, so on that edge, you're drawing that line, and there's a point there which should makes this side the same length as that side, so that this becomes a square. And you can follow that all the way around. So same thing with those two points there. Okay, so those parallel lines take you to this stage. Now when we join that to that, we're going to have a square there. When we join here to here, we're going to have a triangle here. And if we follow that all the way around, we end up with a dodecagon, six squares, six triangles, and a hexagon in the middle. Okay, there we have the dodecagon divided into hexagons and triangles. Now I'll just point out this point. To draw this pattern, to make one tile of this pattern, that is all you need. The reason we've done the extended thing is to make a nicer final drawing, which will have those six pointed stars around it. So the final composition will be more interesting, but if you're just constructing this just for the for one tile, you can just use this. And you would join there, and that will make your hexagon. I'll explain this again later when we get to that stage. Okay, everyone doing all right with that? Yeah, good. All right, if you've already done that, then we extend this a bit further. We put a hexagon in each of these surrounding ones, and now you'll see why we had to draw these lines to get those two points. Hexagons there, and then just join those up and we have the final grid. Now something you may notice is the side of that line there will be part of the same, so you can always line it up in one go. with you, okay?
Yeah, this is, you don't need that. From here, so it's to that point and that point, then when you do, something before.
Yeah, right. Right, while you guys are finishing, I'll just explain a bit about this tiling. This is known as one of the Archimedean tilings. It's made up of three shapes, hexagon, triangle, and square. The sides of every shape are the same length, which is kind of obvious, because that central hexagon, that side is part of the square, and that side of the square is part of the triangle. So all these lines are all the same length, all the way around, and you can extend that, and there are other configurations of squares, triangles, hexagons that you can also make. Now when we draw the pattern, okay, now that I've got an idea that it's taken a little while to get this far, I think we might not do the real, we'll do two patterns. So let me just show you where it goes from here. Now this pattern, the first version of this, there's a couple more things we need to do, a couple more lines to add, and then we can do it quite easily. And the way this pattern works, so let me just show you. So we add a few more lines in, and then the final pattern is made up of these three shapes. So in what's happening here is the center point of each side of the polygon, there's a line coming out from it, two lines coming out from it at a particular angle, and it's the same all the way around. So this is a method, Jean-Marc talked about this in his talk yesterday, it's a sort of well-established method in contact. And essentially what's happening is because the lines are coming out at the same angle, when you finish the pattern, the lines all connect up. When you remove the polygons, these lines will just extend into longer connected lines, and then we can expand that to this. This one on the side, this is a midpoint. So then I want to take it one step further, and what's happening here is on each side we have a point, so the grey line is the pattern we're going to draw first. The black line is the one we'll develop after. And on this one, along the side, these two points, that's one third and two thirds of the way along. So you can see that they're very related patterns, but we have this one, simple version, and this one, the more complex version. We're gonna add a couple more lines because what we need to do to draw this pattern is to find the midpoint of every side. Now you can see this square, we have the midpoint here, we have the midpoint here. This triangle, we have all three midpoints. This hexagon, we have the midpoints. What we don't have is midpoint of this one. So we just need a few more lines. So these are quite easy to do. These ones I would do in the 2H pencil again, so keep it fairly light. So the first set we do by joining, what am I using, blue? So we're gonna connect these six hexagons around the outside. We're connecting the center points of each one, and you can see if I connect that point and that point, I've got a midpoint there and a midpoint there. So you can draw that in. And then do the same all the way around. So we now have the midpoints of every polygon. One last thing we need is, inside each square, right, do you see here, the line from this six-pointed star is extending, and it stops here on the diagonal of this square. Now at the moment, we don't have that diagonal marked. So we need to add a cross inside each square. All the triangles, hexagons are all fine. They've already got all their markings. So these squares just need, you just join the corner points so you've got that diagonal. That will be useful for the next stage. So that is just done by connecting the opposite corners of a square, like that. So if you've never done any geometric drawing construction like this before by hand, there are quicker, simpler methods for constructing patterns, obviously digitally. In my own work, I use both methods, and I find both avenues give different insights into the exploration of these types of patterns and the tilings and the structures. What you get out of the speed and possibilities of using a computer, you lose in the slowness and the thoroughness and the sort of insight you get from just physically connecting. There's a direct connection between your brain and your hand. You go into a computer, it's brain to hand, to another brain, to a screen. So the whole thing, you know, it's a different experience. I find this is a very engaging way. And there are certain things, like say you want to divide into six, you can just make a line, rotate by 60 degrees, which is very easy and quick, and it frees your mind up to think about other things. This method, you know, there's something meticulous and rigorous about looking for methods that allow you to find the midpoint of each side, or as we will move on to, finding the third points of each side. So I strongly recommend, you know, working by hand as well. It's not always the correct technique that's gonna, depending on the way you're gonna apply it, but you know, the actual act of drawing, there's nothing quite like that. There's nothing, the directness of that connection is, you know, you don't really get that in other methods. So if everyone's kind of got to that stage, we're going to put another sheet of tracing paper. Let me just check that's right. Yep. So tracing paper, and then we can start drawing the first version of this pattern. But the way I've drawn it on screen is not the way I would suggest drawing it on your sheet. I've drawn it like this on the computer so you can see the three elements that make up the whole pattern. Basically, that's if you extend that round everything, that's going to give you the full pattern. So six-pointed star in every hexagon. The extension of the, then you could say triangle inside the triangle unit, and then extending those lines gives you this motif in the square. The way I would probably do it is to start with the central six-pointed star. Now, let me try and it's the pattern's coming from the connection of the midpoints of each side. Now, when you do that six-pointed star, if you all want to just look here for a minute, let me just explain how the six-pointed star works. Now there's a section here, so it's made up of two triangles, one triangle and then an upside down triangle. But this section here, you don't need to draw that in. So looking here, if I start from this midpoint and I join to this midpoint, you go through four of these segments. So this is 1/12 of the circle, there's four of them you go through. So you just draw the line in the first one, then you skip these two, and you draw the line in the second one, and you extend the line outside the hexagon up to the diagonal cross inside the square. Okay, so I'll just say that again. From this midpoint, so that's the side of a hexagon, that's the side of a hexagon, midpoint to midpoint, you're drawing that section, leaving out these two, draw that section, and extend it to the diagonal. Okay? As I draw it, hopefully it'll be clearer as well. Just occurred to me that we're going to use that same grid for the next version. I think mine's going to get very cluttered, so I might just try and stick some tracing paper together. The main thing to remember is that you're joining the midpoints of each side. Okay, so that's the central, some of you probably already done this, the central six-pointed star, and the lines are extending into the square. Then if you put in the triangle, so again joining the midpoints of the triangle and extending the line to there. So the main thing is you're drawing the six-pointed stars and the triangles. What happens in the square just comes from the extension of the lines. So here I'm drawing the triangle, but I'm extending it from there and going again, there's a diagonal inside the square. I'm extending to there. Then I'll do the same this way. Okay, so now you can see it starting to take shape. There's going to be the triangle, this four-pointed star and six-pointed star, and the in-between shapes are popping up now, and you have this slightly strange heptagon, seven-sided shape. It's not regular, but kind of interesting result of the rest of the shapes. So has anyone got... Yeah, so I did the star, the six-pointed star, and extended those lines. Now I'm inside, so if I do it, I'll do it again here on this one. So here we have the midpoint, so we've got a triangle tile, midpoints of the triangle tile. I'm basically putting a triangle in there, but the lines will extend and they will meet these lines. So again, that one will extend and meet that one. So you're using this point and this point as your guide for alignment, and then you're extending that up to, inside the square you've got a diagonal there. So you go from this diagonal, through that point on the triangle, through that point on the triangle, and down to there. Okay? All right. Start to see that this four-pointed star is taking shape. Once we put in the star in these outer six hexagons, everything will be pretty much finished, I think. So you're joining from that point to that point. And you stop there. No. And then you extend it here as well. So it goes to there. Right. Then the next big ruler. So now you're going from this side, miss that side, join to that point. And then this one will join to this one. So here, again you go from that point, but you start at this diagonal. Go through there, stop there, stop from there, miss that point. And then on this one, same thing. Through that point, stop there, then from there, through the point, up to there. Okay, and then you do the same thing the other way, so here, and you extend the lines there, and then it starts to happen, yeah? Okay, this is all correct, it's, so from this point to this point, it's gonna, but it's, you don't do that this part, so you do from here
and here, and then you join there, and this one will extend and join to there. Yeah, so this section, this section, and then from this one, you go to this point, and you would.
Right, I'll just give you a little idea of what we're going to do after the break. So we're going to start with the same grid tiling, add a few more lines. So it looks like a lot, but there's a few lines to put in, and then we just build the same thing up. Now you can see here, we've now got the third points on the sides there. Extend a few lines, and then we're putting in this, which is very similar to the six-pointed star that we've already done, but it's a double line, so these two lines either side of the original one, same sort of thing. So you can see it's the same four-pointed star, but again a double line version. Same thing with the triangles to extend to that. And then, you know, once you've got that far, you'll be able to do the rest in your own time if we don't manage to finish. So that being the result, that's one single tile unit with color added and turned into a tessellated pattern. So if you take, once you've got that basic structure, you can expand it into as much of a tiling as you want. So it may look a lot more complicated, but we've already done half of this by making that tiling. Then it's just a few more steps. So we'll have a pattern. You've been drawing the last pattern on tracing paper. Even if you haven't finished that, hopefully you understand enough to be able to finish it in your own time. So if you take off that top sheet, we want to go back to the basic tiling grid. So back to where this is, and put a new sheet of tracing paper on. Does everyone need more? Just to remind you, the pattern we've already drawn was using the midpoint of each of these sides. So the side of every one of these polygons, hexagon, square, triangle, all the sides are the same length. We found the midpoint, and then that allowed us to make the pattern. We're going to do basically the same pattern, but this time we're using two points on each side. So we need to divide the side of each polygon into three. So in order to do this, I'll just run through the steps and then we'll go through it one by one. So we're putting in three different six-pointed stars. So we put in that star, we put another one in that inside hexagon and extend those lines. That's now divided, the sides of the hexagon are now divided into three. We just fill in a few extra lines which help us to determine the section in the square. Then we fill in all those ones, a couple of extra lines in the triangle, and that's basically given us what we need to then construct the pattern. Everything's there, then you just draw the pattern on a new sheet to make it tidy. So, okay, so we start from this one. Now, this is the same type of six-pointed star from the other pattern. It's basically two triangles, one triangle there, one triangle there. So I'll just draw that in. Right, everyone ready for next step? So next step, we're basically, you can see in the middle of this, you have another hexagon inside that star. We're going to make another six-pointed star in there, but this time the lines will extend. So here, inside that hexagon, you can see another six-pointed star. The lines here, we're going to extend them all the way to that diagonal. So six-pointed star with the extensions. So here inside this, so we drew this one. Inside this hexagon in the middle, we do another six-pointed star, and we extend the lines going all the way up to these diagonals all the way around. So the first step we did was this six-pointed star. Then in the center of that, so that's given us a new hexagon in the middle. So then we've gone to add a new six-pointed star in there and extended those lines. You use the, in this hexagon. So you made drawing a star in there by connecting two triangles like that. So these 6 points, there starts to be quite a lot of lines here, it's a bit hard to pick out, but I'll just draw in blue around these 6 points. Right, we're adding one more 6-pointed star, so let me point out that the side of each of the hexagon is now divided into three. All the way around, we've got the third points. Now, it's just that we need to connect along there for the pattern to work. So we're adding one more six-pointed star. Now, how this works is, along this, if I show you on this side, you have that point and that point. Those are the one-third and two-third points along that side. Now, the corresponding point, hang on, here. Right, you see this point to this point, if I join those two together, and again, I'm extending up to the diagonal, the first diagonal inside the square. Okay, so along this side, we already have the one-third and two-third, and here, one-third, two-third. So we're joining this point to this point, and just extend up to the diagonal again. This point. Same thing will happen down here, this one here, to this one here. Okay, so I drew in dark green there. So it's here to here, and here to here. And then you do the same three more times. It gives you another six-pointed star. The reason we're doing this is this is telling us, so we've already got what we need for the central star. What we don't have is what's happening in the square and the triangle. So here we're starting to fill in the lines that we need for the square, and then we'll do a couple more lines for the triangle, and then it all works. Now, the good thing here is you're going to do it once here, you're going to do it six more times around the edge. So by that point, it'll have gone in your head, hopefully. I can see everyone's got different levels of experience of having drawn these types of patterns before. What we did earlier this morning, if you're finding this is just too many lines, too much confusion, stick with the first one and just try and finish that off and understand it, because I don't think we all finished actually filling in that pattern. And if you just try, let me just bring it up again. So talking about this one, so if you feel that this is going over your head, if you go back to this one and just try and make sure the lines are all continual, you know, that they don't just sort of stop and break there, and that this angle changes here, you know, that these are all straight and connected and it comes out looking nice, and then maybe go over it again a bit harder, something like that. If you're feeling that what I'm talking about now is too much, if you're following it, that's fine. It's just there's this new one, there's a lot more construction lines. And when you're looking at this, you know, maybe it's the first or second time you've drawn a pattern like this, looking at that and trying to understand what's coming out of that, it's a big jump. Lucky I didn't do the next pattern, which is, yeah, I think that would have not gone very well. So yeah, if you feel comfortable just with the first one and just trying to develop that, that's a good place to do it. Hopefully some of you are going to do this though. Right, for those of you who are doing this, same again all the way around. And so what's happening here, you can see we're starting to get the lines in these sections. Then when we fill in this triangle, the triangle and these bits here will get filled in, and then we're almost there. So this a bit time consuming, but if you do that around the edge. Right, next step for this one, what's missing is the third points in the triangle, and once we have those, we'll be able to complete the squares as well. So, you see here, so the points that we've created by extending these lines to meet the diagonal and extending these lines to meet, so there's a square, there's a diagonal, there's a square, there's a diagonal. Where these two meet, and you should be able to tell whether you're hitting the right points or not, because inside that triangle it should be one third of the way along, and you'll end up with, once you've done these lines, inside that triangle you'll have 9 smaller triangles. You're dividing that triangle into 9. So first step here, I want a line going there, and it's from that point to that point. Just try and do this in a different colour. Actually no, I'll do it in the same colour, it's going to get too confusing. So here, there you can see that this point here where it hits the diagonal and this one here, if I join those together, I'm going through the center of this triangle. So if you see, we've got these blue lines already. These are actually just dividing these angles in half. So it's another way you can look at it. If you look where that line should be, you'll see that it lines up with that point and that point there. Like that. And then one more. Okay? Then the next bit's easy. You've got you've got three triangles here. We just need a line there, and a line there to divide the rest. And again, those will hit the diagonal point. So that's now divided that one, and then okay, so now hopefully you can see, if you look inside the square, we've got all these lines filling up in the square. When I do the same here, that square will be filled. Okay, so if I put this same thing that I did here, here, then this triangle, this square will be filled. Once we've done this, we can start drawing the pattern. So I'll just do that again. So I'm going through the middle of this triangle and joining the points on the diagonals here, there, through there, up to there. Actually, that should have extended there. And then one this way. And one that way. Sheet of tracing paper for this final pattern stage. For those of you who've done the first pattern, if you finished it, you try colouring it or whatever you want. So that's the first start. Now everything, this, you've done the difficult bit, this is the easy bit. This is just picking out which lines make the pattern and leaving out the rest. So now that we drew all this stuff in, I'll pick out the key shape, but then I'll show you how you should draw it, because really, instead of just drawing this, if you extend these lines, then you don't have to, it's the same as the last one. You draw this part and you draw the triangle part, and the extensions of those lines will fill in the square. You don't need to actually draw the square. Everyone looks at these things differently. If you want, you can draw the square just by itself, draw the triangles by themselves, but you know, these lines are all long straight lines. So actually, when you have, if you just draw that and you draw that and then you connect those, it's more likely to have a few wobbles in it. Whereas if you just do that whole line in one go, it's, you know, but everyone sees it differently. If it's easier for you to draw each tile separately, do it that way. So this central star, I should also point out this grid is, so the tiling itself, the main tiling with the hexagon, square, triangle, that's a key tiling. That's a very fundamental tiling which you can use for a whole range of patterns. In addition to that, the way we've broken this down into a grid of threes, you can see within there you've got smaller hexagons. That one's all divided into 12 already. So from that grid, if you go away from here and you want to try experimenting, you know, there are a lot of things. If you, and I'll, in a minute before we finish, I will explain a bit about some of the options with using these tiles and looking at what you can do with just the hexagon tile or just the triangle. If you were constructing this star in just the hexagon, you might approach the method differently. So But seeing as you've done this, you can then take one of those and repeat just that, or just this triangle and repeat that, or the square, or different combinations of them. And I've got examples of all of that. So, you know, this is divided up in a very logical, mathematical way, and there are many other possibilities of what you can do from there. So just, you know, have a play with that. So this pattern, we're gonna just do, the key element is, you can see that shape is this shape here, six times round makes that, and then actually it's the extensions of those lines. So really the way I would draw it, instead of just drawing that segment of the line, I would extend that line into the square. It's gonna stop, actually it's gonna continue to there along that section, through there, through the middle of that square. Now sometimes the first time you do it, it's easier just to draw the central star, get a feel for what's going on. If any of you enjoy doing all of this, it's not for everyone, but if you've enjoyed it, then drawing all this again from the beginning, you'll find the second time you do it, because you've done it once, you know what's happened, you know where you're going, you do it a second time, it'll come out 10 times better. And also you'll find, you'll be able to see what's happening here. So at the moment, this may look like a mess of lines to you, but once you start seeing what's coming out, which bits you need to pull out, you can then just do it in longer straight lines, you know, even going all the way straight across. But like I say, everyone sees these things a bit differently, so. So what we'll do is there to there. You can see the central six-pointed star inside the hexagon tile with the extended lines that start going into the square part. Then if I just draw the two of the triangles in, you'll start to see it all come together. Okay, so there's enough there that you start to see what's going on. You've got central, the double star inside the hexagon, double star inside the triangle, and double star inside the square. And if you notice, the original pattern was made up of six-pointed star, four-pointed star, triangle. The six-pointed star there in the center, four-pointed star there, triangle, there are a few of them around. And then it's that funny seven-sided shape here, which in the first pattern, this is just smaller. So, right, let me just show you. So that's just showing just the tiling and the first pattern. There you can see the second pattern that we've drawn. And once you finish the two, you can overlay the tracing paper and see this happening. So here in grey, we've got the six-pointed star. And now we've done a double version. So the lines are just equally either side of it. So instead of joining at the midpoint of the side, they're joining at the one-third and two-third points of the side. So they're related patterns. It basically is the same pattern. It's just been applied in a slightly different way. And then if we remove the other one, this is what you'll end up with, this pattern. So I'll just show you some of the ideas about tiling. So if we look at this is the central part of this. So we've got a hexagon tile in the middle, surrounded by triangles and squares to make a dodecagon. So if we highlight the three tiles from that, we've got hex, and this applies with the first pattern. It would just be just a six-pointed star, a four-pointed star, and a triangle. So this is based on the second pattern, but you've got three tiles. Now, these three shapes happen to be the only regular polygons that can tessellate on their own. So a hexagon will tessellate by itself. It doesn't need another shape, and it can tessellate, which means fill a flat plane with no gaps. Same with the square, same with the triangle. They're the only regular polygons, meaning the sides are all the same length, the internal angles are all the same. There's no other shape that this happens with. So we've now created three different tiles, which we can use individually or in different combinations. We've done this in this particular tiling, but here are some other examples. So here, hopefully you can just about see the central tile picked out, but this is just that tile repeated, and I believe this is what you see in the Sultan Ahmet Mosque on the floor. This one, which is just triangular tile, I've highlighted three of them, and here you have the tile upside down, but this is just a grid of repeating triangles. So these are all possible things that can arise out of this pattern, treating the tiles differently. And that's just the square unit there, repeated to make another pattern. So whether these are natural developments from the original pattern and from the original principle. So although drawing it in this way, there are a lot of lines and a lot of construction, and the thing gets very complicated, and you kind of need to be able to see what to pick out and what to leave. The actual principle is very simple. You've got tiles of different shapes, and you're finding either the midpoint or the third points on the side, and you're having two lines coming at an angle from those points, and the angle's always the same, and it applies the same to all the tiles. And this is how a lot of Islamic patterns work, using polygons, finding midpoints, putting intersection lines that are the same all the way around. This is why you get this effect where, although this is the tile, this line just continues into the next tile, and it just develops from there, which is where you have these long interweaving lines. Yeah, so that's the hexagon tile. And if you want to construct just that one tile, you would draw a square. You would find a method for finding the third point and the third point. And then, you know, the rest of it is going to be a development from that. Hexagons and triangles can also tessellate together. So this is combining two shapes. So you can see a hexagon surrounded by six triangles, and then in here you'd have another hexagon few more triangles. So this is a tessellation, not with one shape, but two. And then that can be extended into the pattern that we created here. So square, triangle, hexagon, tessellated to make this pattern. Now, to make this pattern, if you were actually creating tiles and you're going to use them, applying it to a wall or a floor, you probably don't want to have three different tile shapes to play around with and figure out how they fit together. So this can actually be broken down even further into one hexagonal tile. Don't know how clear that is to see from where you are. Not that clear. Joining here, to here, to here, to here, to here. And then that hexagonal tile is one repeatable tile. So you're taking what started as three tiles and making a single tile from it. Now, if we'd just been drawing this, this whole business would have been a lot simpler, but I wanted to do it like this to have a more interesting final composition, which is the drawing that was up right at the beginning, which is probably worth seeing again. That. So that's the finished drawing that we created. Now, if we just created the central part, it's a nice design. It's all you need to actually repeat this, but to make this full design, it's nicer, and you get to see, if you only have this central section, you only have the one six-pointed star. So having the six-pointed stars all the way around, having these squares all the way around, makes a nicer overall composition. And from that, you can actually extend the idea and join the center points to make a single hexagonal tile from that, which is what I did. So I've gone from that, joined the centers of those six-pointed stars, made one hexagonal tile, added color to that, and then when that's repeated, you get a pattern where if you'd made a smaller tile, every one of these six-pointed stars would have been the same. Because it's one central star with six part stars around it, you're able to have one color here, different colors here, and it just creates a more of an undulating rhythm. So, yeah, that's kind of... Thank you very much, and hopefully see you tomorrow.